you know that when you're feeling something, it shows on your face?
That's true.
Do you know
I just tickled Ruby and she smiled.
That's right. See, she's feeling funny.
I have tickles today.
You have, huh?
What'd you do, leave your face at home?
Huh? Hey, you want to play a face game?
Yeah.
Come on, let's do it. It's fun. Okay, you ready?
Ready, here we go.
Oh, he's ready. Let's make a face, make a face, make a happy face. That's a happy face. Shine up your eyes, make your eyes shine all over the place. Slap on a smile where you think a smile should be. That's a happy, happy face, the nicest face to see.
Let's make a face, make an angry face. Let your eyes down, make a big frown all over the place. Curl up your chin just as far as it can go. That's the best way to make an angry face, I know.
Face has been known to break down and cry, then slip into a grin.
A face is a place that changes to fit the mood you're in.
That's right.
Let's make a face, make a face.
Make a surprised face.
Open your eyes, make your eyes wine all over the place.
Your mouth just as big as it can be.
And make a happy face.
Make an angry face.
Make a surprise face. A surprising face to see. Let's make a face, make a face.
Make any kind of face.
Right. Make a frown or a smile. Flash your own style all over the place.
Don't be afraid to let your feelings show. With a happy or a sad face.
An angry or a glad face.
A funny or surprised face. A puzzled or a wise face. Let a face go where it wants to go. Make a face.
The Sesame Street Little Theater proudly presents Let's Make a Face. Oh, welcome to our little play. We are ever so glad that you joined us today. Now, let's make a face. It's a great thing to do. We'll start with the parts, for there are quite a few.
Now, these are a part of the face, it is true. Sometimes they're greenish, or brown, black, or blue. You use them to see with, you call them your eyes. Whatever the color, they look very nice.
Nice?
This is a nose. It's a thing that you smell with. It's a thing that a face always really looks swell with. Sometimes it's pointed, and sometimes it's round, and sometimes it's worn on the face upside down.
No, it is not. Now you cut that out, Harry.
Me next?
Yeah, you're next, Cookie.
He forgot what this picture of.
It's a mouth.
Oh, yeah. This is the part of the face me like best. It whole lot more fun than all of the rest. For smiling and frowning and laughing, it neat thing. But me like a mouth best when it busy eating. Oh, yeah, like chocolate chip cookies and macaroon cookies and
cookie
cookies. You guys got cookies!
Okay, guys, you next.
You ready, Grover?
Yes, I am, Bert.
Okay.
Now, here are two things that are really exciting. With them, you can hear this nice verse we're reciting. For these parts of the face, let's give three big loud cheers.
For these are the things that we all call our belly buttons.
Ears! We rehearsed it, I tell you!
Oh,
ears!
I'm sorry,
it's ears!
I forgot, bro!
No! Oh, come on, guys. Get it right.
Let's get it right.
Yay, that's it.
Yay!
We've made a nice face, and we hope you've had fun.
The nose. It's right in the middle of your face. And it's a nifty sort of thing, and I thought I would tell you a few things about what a nose can do. Well, now first of all, you can breathe with your nose. I am now going to breathe with my nose. Okay, so much for that. Now let me see. What else can you do with your nose? I know. You can smell things with your nose. You can smell things like these pretty flowers. See? Okay, now let me see. What else can you do with your nose? Hey, you know what I can do with my nose? I can wiggle my nose real good. Now watch. Gee, you know, I can't think of anything else. Now what else can I... Oh, I knew there was something else. A nose can sneeze.
Greetings. I am the Count. Do you know what? Look. Flowers. I will count them. One flower. Two flowers. Three flowers. Four flowers. Five flowers. Six flowers. Seven flowers. I love to count flowers. Do you know why I love to count flowers? Because flowers make me sneeze. And now, after I count the flowers, I can count sneezes. One sneeze. Two sneezes. Three sneezes. Four sneezes. Five sneezes. Six sneezes.
7 wonderful sneezes. I love it.
Once upon a time in the land of 8, there stood a castle very great, and 8 flags waved in the air, for the king of 8 had put them there.
I'm the king of 8, and I'm here to state that everything here has to total 8. The guards, for instance, by the gate, must always number exactly 8.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
In my castle in back of me are 8 windows, you can see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In those windows are my daughters. Show yourselves, my dears.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Each daughter has a silver crown with 8 jewels going round.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
So I love 8. 8 is great. 8 is the number I do not...
Wait, important news comes from the queen, a new baby, and I have seen that she is well and doing fine.
Good grief, it's princess number 9.
Baba?
Yes?
You love me?
Yes, I love you, John John.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Count this penny. Count this penny.
Count that penny?
Yeah, count it.
Okay.
Count.
1.
Right.
Today's secret drawing is the letter M.
Now make a straight line.
No!
No! No!
The other way.
The up and down way.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now make a slanty one going down the right side.
Well, look like a rocket ship.
A little bit neater.
Put it down.
Make it a little bit neater.
No, erase it and make it neater.
Yeah!
And make a straight line.
It's no, like
no, no, no.
That's an A.
Yeah.
Now make it.
Now make it straight like the first one. Like
yeah,
the first one.
But
no.
Not over here.
On the other
up
side.
Up on the right side.
No.
Up on
no.
the right
yeah.
side.
Yeah, yeah. yeah. Now go up.
Go.
Go.
Come on.
Go.
Go. Come on.
Keep on going.
Come on.
Stop.
Okay, take
yeah, that.
Yeah.
Now what is it?
Hey, it's two mountains shaking hands.
No!
It's mouse ears.
No!
I know. It's a moth.
No!
It's a capital.
It's a letter in the alphabet.
Then it must be the letter M.
Yeah!
What do you think about when you're happy, Shola?
I think about all kinds of things.
Like what?
Like playing or dancing. That's nice.
Bert, let me see you be happy.
Okay, here's me happy, okay?
Okay, here's Bert happy. Okay, Shala, your turn. Be happy. Oh, that's good happy.
It's a big smile.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, how about you, Ernie? yeah.
That's when I'm happy.
You know what I act like when I'm sad? That's
What's
good,
that?
Shala. That's like Ernie. Yeah, I'm gonna show you what I am like when I'm sad, okay?
Okay.
Here you go.
Okay, Shala. Your turn.
Be sad.
Be sad.
That's
oh, no. You gotta be sadder than that. Is that sad?
Yeah. You mean sad now, right?
Is that enough?
I think it's enough.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, that's enough.
I don't like being sad.
How about being frightened?
Oh, look at that!
Ooh.
Oh.
Shala looks pretty frightened.
That was good.
Okay, Bert, let me see you be frightened.
Okay. How's that?
Pretty good.
Fine.
Pretty good.
How about you, Ernie?
Well, let's see. What'll I be frightened of?
Think of a 10-foot pigeon.
A what?
A 10-foot monster pigeon. And that's being happy.
Oh, well, I wouldn't be frightened of a 10-foot pigeon.
What can you think of to be mad,
Shala?
Not to be mad, I mean to be scared.
What are you frightened of, Shala?
I'm afraid of monsters.
Monsters. Oh, monsters. Oh, let me hide behind you.
I don't know.
That's enough for now.
Yeah.
Is that enough?
Yes.
That's pretty good. Pretty good. How about mad? You want to see me get mad?
Yeah.
Okay.
Bert's good at getting mad.
That's mad.
Pretty mad, Bert.
Yeah. You be mad,
Shala.
Now, Shala.
Your turn. Be mad.
I'm angry.
Yeah. How about you, Ernie?
I don't believe she's really angry, though. Okay, I'll be angry. What did you do? What? What? I'm not very good at being mad either, Bert.
Yeah.
You're great at it, though.
Thanks.
All I have to do is mess up the room.
Thanks.
Like I just did.
Did you mess up this room again?
Well, Bert, it was just,
Did you mess up this room again?
That's very good, Bert.
Hi, I'm Donna Budd, and I want you to know I'm number one fiddle in this number show. Here's two little toucans, one and two. Do a little dance to do at the zoo. It's called the two-step. Oh, take two steps on the tips of your toes. Take two steps, that's the way it goes. Dance one, two on the tips of your toes. Careful not to step on your girlfriend's nose. One,
two, one, two, one, two, one, two.
Well, that's it. It's easy to do. All you have to do is count to two.
One, two, 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 one, two.
We have two toucans, two hairy news can, two caribou can count to two. Two kangaroos can, even cuckoos can, and my friends, so can you.
One, two, 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 one, two.
Now, what starts with the letter C? Cookie starts with C. Let's think of other things that start with C. Who cares about other things? C is for cookie. That's good enough for me. C is for cookie. That's good enough for me. C is for cookie. That's good enough for me. Oh, cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C. Oh, C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. Oh, cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C. Hey, you know what? A round cookie with one bite out of it looks like a C. A round donut with one bite out of it also looks like a C. But it is not as good as a cookie. Oh, the moon sometimes looks like a C, but you can't eat that. So, C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. Yeah, C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. Oh, cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C. Yeah, cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C. Oh boy, cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C.
No, 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 no. N. Ha. Nose. Ha. Thank you.
Hey, Bud.
Oh, me?
Shh!
Oh, me?
Right. Hey, come here. How would you like to buy this here invisible ice cream cone?
Invisible ice cream cone?
Right.
I don't see any invisible ice cream cone.
Well, of course you don't see it. That's what invisible means. You can't see it.
Oh, you can't see it.
Mm.
I see.
Right. Well, now, I'm going to let you have this invisible cone here for just one nickel.
One nickel?
Shh!
One nickel?
Right.
Well, what do I need an invisible ice cream cone for?
What do you need an invisible ice cream cone for?
I asked you first.
Look, come in. Now, supposing you was walking down the street, eating one of your regular ice cream cones, huh? You was really enjoying that cone, when all of a sudden, unbeknownst to you, from behind a tree, out jumped Louis the Lip.
Louis the Lip!
Shh.
Ah!
Shh, shh, shh.
Who's Louis the Lip?
He is the most famous ice cream thief in the world.
Oh, and there I am, walking down the street, eating an ice cream cone that anybody could see.
Right.
So he would run over and take it right out of my hands, leaving me with no ice cream.
Right.
Oh, terrible.
But if you had this here invisible ice cream cone, Louis would not see it. So he'd just walk right on by and you'd still have one beautiful ice cream cone to eat.
Oh, hey, that's wonderful. I'll take it.
Terrific.
Wait a minute. What flavor is it?
Chocolate.
Oh, I don't like chocolate. Thanks anyhow.
Oh, kid. Ho. Come here.
What?
What flavor do you like?
Well, my very favorite flavor is Banana Royale Tootsie Fruitsy.
Banana Royale
Tootsie
Fruitsy.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
It's my favorite.
You got it.
Oh, hey, wonderful.
Give me the nickel.
Okay, here you go. Right here.
Yeah.
All right.
Ho, kid.
Hmm?
You didn't give me nothing.
Sure I did. That's an invisible nickel.
Put it right here. Now then, which side do you want out? The picture side or the glue side?
That's hard to decide.
The glue side is pretty.
Good. We'll stick it on the wall with the glue side out.
That isn't right. Pictures are for looking at and glue is for sticking. Maybe we should put the picture side out.
My son, the genius. We'll put it up with the glue side toward the wall and the picture side out.
Yay!
Right. here we go.
That isn't right. Maybe you didn't stick it to the wall hard enough, Daddy.
I hear you talking, daughter. I'll try again.
That wasn't right.
It certainly wasn't.
Wait a minute. I know what's wrong.
What's wrong, Tina?
The glue on a postage stamp doesn't get sticky until you lick it.
My daughter, the super brain. Come on, everybody. Help me lick the stamp.
Yes.
There we go.
This stamp isn't too yummy.
Keep licking.
Come on, children. There. All done.
Good. And now we stick it on the wall like this.
Now that's right.
Mm-hmm.
At least I think it's right.
Does that look right?
Maybe George Washington liked to stand on his head.
I
don't know.
I don't know either.
I don't know. Me too.
What do you think, Ma?
Tis a puzzle, then. I think I'll go to bed, Timmy.
Me too. I'll come along.
All right, let's go to bed, Daddy.
Okay, Mother. Let's go.
I think we made it.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, the coast is clear.
Yeah.
Come here.
Right.
Hey, yeah. We made it.
Right.
We got the golden Anne.
Right.
Look at it, isn't it beautiful?
Beautiful.
Yeah, you see there's an Anne.
Yeah.
See, an A and an N together make Anne.
Yeah, hey, well, what are we gonna do with it now, boss?
Ah, this is where you come into the plan,
yeah?
Lefty. You see that van?
That tan van.
Right.
Yeah, right.
Well, look, I want you to take this golden Anne in the tan van.
Right.
Give it to Dan, who will take it to Fran. You understand?
Lay it on me once more. Just a few parts,
okay. Look, this will make it easier for you.
Yeah.
Look, everything that I'm telling you about the plan rhymes with Anne. You see? Now you take the golden Anne in the tan van. You give it to Dan, who takes it to Fran.
Right, I understand. Right.
One more thing.
Yeah.
Now look. Every policeman in the city is after this golden Anne.
Right.
So don't tell the plan to anyone.
Gotcha, right.
Okay, good luck, Lefty.
Right, thanks. Yeah. Go ahead. Now, let's see. I take the golden Anne and I put it in that tan truck. No. The tan van, that's it, tan van. I take the golden Anne, I put it in the tan van, and I take it to Horace, who... No. Wait a minute. Oh, I know, wait. They rhyme, that's it, the words rhyme. So, let's see, I take the golden Anne, yeah, and I take it and put it in the tan van. That's it. And then, I take it to Dan, right, who takes it to Fran. That's the plan, yeah.
That's the plan?
Who said that?
My name's Stan. I'm the man. You just got 10 days in the can for stealing the golden Anne. Let's go.
Yeah.
Come on.
I should have ran.
Okay. Yeah, a little more of this, Sully. Yeah, that ought to do it, huh? You know, moving this here piano reminds me of the time when I was a kid and I used to do them scales, you know, on the piano, that do, re, mi, fatso, laddie, do. Gee, I wonder if I could still do that. Let me see if I can still do them. I'm a little rusty, you know?
Yeah, practice. You gotta practice when you wanna play the scale. Yeah, well, you know, it's like anything. When you're learning something, you gotta keep doing it over and over and practice it and not give up is the main thing. Right, Sully? Right. Yeah, well, you know, you get a little rusty. I'm gonna go get the truck so we can get this thing loaded. Been playing the chopstick, Sully? Let me try that scale one more time there. Hey, did you hear that? I did it, huh? I played that scale real great, didn't I, Sully? Hey, that was fantastic. You see what a little practice will do for you? Let's get this piano on the truck here. The whole secret's keeping your fingers loose, Sully. Loose.
Above or upside down, from the top or the bottom, in front or behind, are you turning it
hi all, Kermit the Frog here with the cultural part of the Sesame Street news, because today we're speaking to you from the home of that very famous songwriter, Mr. Don Music, who's writing a brand new hit song right now. Let's see how he's doing, shall we? Why not?
Mary had a little lamb. Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow. And everywhere that Mary went, Mary went, Mary went. And everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to.
Oh, I'll never get it. Oh, I'm sorry, Ludwig. Oh!
Excuse me. Pardon me. Don. Mr. Music. Excuse me, Don. Listen, I'm Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News.
Yes.
What seems to be the trouble?
Well, it's my new song. I can't find a word to rhyme with snow. I must have a lyric that sounds like snow. Something that lambs do that sounds like snow.
Rhyme for snow. Well, listen,
right.
I'm good at rhymes. I do a rhyme all the time. You hear that? I did a rhyme just then.
That's very nice, but
you want one that lambs do.
Right. I'll never get it. Never! Oh!
You'll hurt yourself in the head there, Don. Tell me, Don, you okay?
Yes.
What do little lambs do, anyhow?
Well, they go baa and
Well,
they run around a lot. That's it. They run all the time. They run.
That's it.
That's
run.
It?
Yes, that's a good one.
Oh.
Get this. Mary had a little lamb. Its fleece was white as snow. And everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to run.
Oh, but that doesn't rhyme with snow. It must sound like snow.
Well, it doesn't have to sound like snow.
Of course
snow.
It does.
No, it doesn't.
Oh.
Listen, we can change that part.
We can?
Sure. Sure, change it around. Get this. Mary had a little lamb. Its fleece was yellow as the sun. And everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to run.
No, I don't think that'll work. Lambs aren't yellow. I mean, who ever heard of a yellow lamb?
Well, I've heard of a yellow lamb.
You have?
Well, not many, but... Hmm. Well, we can... What else is yellow? Something else is yellow.
I don't know. Canaries are yellow.
Canaries. You got it.
That's it?
Sure.
Oh.
Ready? Mary had a little canary. It was yellow as the sun. And everywhere that Mary went, the canary was sure to run.
No, that won't work. Canaries don't run. They fly mostly, I think.
True. You got a point. We can correct that. You ready?
How are we going to correct that?
Get ready. Here it comes. Mary had a little canary. It was bluer than the sky. And everywhere that Mary went, the canary was sure to fly.
But canaries aren't blue!
Well,
I'll never get it! Never! You won't help, Bo!
Good heavens, Don, you okay?
Oh, Don.
Wait a minute. I got the answer. Hey, Don?
Yes?
Give Mary a bicycle. All you have to do is give Mary a bicycle.
A bicycle?
Sure, a bicycle can be any color you want it to be.
Say, I like right? that. Yeah, I like... Let me write that down.
Sure. Now, what color bicycle. Would you like the bicycle to be there, Don?
Color. The red. Yes, that's it. Red. Good. I like red for bicycles.
Okay. Get this.
Hold on.
Here we go. Mary had a little bicycle. It was painted red as fire. And whenever Mary wanted to take a ride, the bicycle had a flat tire.
I like it! That's great!
It
you
is.
Got a great talent for writing songs.
Yes.
This could be my biggest hit. Would you
Wonderful.
Like to hear it?
Certainly. It would be an honor.
Fine.
Ladies and gentlemen, live and in person, here's Don Music doing his new hit song.
Mary had a bicycle, bicycle, bicycle. Mary had a bicycle. Painted red as fire.
Mary.
And whenever Mary wanted a ride, that's
what?
Right, wanted a ride.
Oh.
She wanted a ride.
Yeah, whenever Mary wanted a ride.
The bicycle had a flat tire.
Mary.
Red, 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 red as fire.
Flat, 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 flat tire. Mary had a bicycle.
But it always had a flat tire.
Mary, flat tire.
There's a great little spot where the dancing is hot and the music is out of sight. They're singing and playing and swinging and swaying. I'm there most every night.
If you went there with me, you would have to agree it's the craziest place you've been.
'Cause every night round 8 o'clock, the alphabet walks in. And when they do, the place really, well, let me describe it to you. A, B, C are the first to arrive, starting cooking to the real gun dive.
D, E, F are next in line, the groovy mellow melodies suit them fine.
Ba-do-ba-do-ba-do-ba-do-ba-do-ba-ba.
Now G-H-I come in the door, they soon start jitterbugging round the floor.
J-K-L says this joint swings, and another of solid funny things like hover-hover in the groove and
shoot the money to me, honey.
Now M and O look over the scene, then they cut a rug, which is really keen. P, Q, and R begin to wail, especially Q, who steps on his tail.
Ouch! Never step on your own tail,
especially when you're dancing.
S, T, U drive up with pride,
but leave the V, W park outside.
While X, Y, Z bring up the rear, shouting,
hey, we really dig it here. Hey, Bob, Reba, man alive.
jam into the jukebox, hit the jive. Well, you can't imagine a funnier sight than 26 ladders that dance all night. And now that we told you, you never forget the cool, crazy, swinging alphabet. Yeah, now that we told you, you'll never forget the cool, crazy, swinging alphabet. Okay, everybody, sing those swinging letters along with us. Ready? Let's go! A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P.
Q, R, S, T, U, V.
W, X, Y, and Z, yeah! Now that we told you, you never forget the cool, crazy, swinging alphabet. A, B, C, X, Y, Z.
And M, O, P spells mom.
Yeah!
Today I'd like to tell you the story of Cutie and the Beast. Now, once upon a time,
Bobby,
in a fu-
baby!
Oh, hiya, Grover. How are you?
Oh, hiya. Oh, sorry.
Oh, that's okay, Grover.
How you doing, Bobby?
I'm doing
Big
fine.
Bobby?
How are you doing?
Oh, good. What you doing there?
Well, I was about to read a story, Grover.
You're going to read a story?
Mm-hmm.
Can Cutie- I be in the story?
You'd like to be in the story?
Oh, yeah, please.
Well, I don't... Well, we do need a beast.
A beast? Oh, I can pretend I'm a beast.
Could you play the part of a beast?
Oh, yeah, I'm a good actor.
Are you sure?
I go over and get ready.
Okay, you go get ready.
You go ahead and read, Big Bob.
Okay, Grover.
Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye, Grover. Anyway, once upon a time in a far-off kingdom, there lived an old king and his delightful daughter. Now, the king was called Ferdinand the 37th, and his daughter was known as Cutie.
Oh, why, that is my name. My name is Cutie.
Yes, I named her Cutie because she's as cute as a bug's ear.
She is kind of cute, isn't she? Huh?
Oh, yes, I am.
Well, anyway, Cutie and her father lived in regal splendor in the castle. And as the years passed, well, it became time for Cutie to be married.
Father?
Yeah?
Is it not time for me to be getting, you know, married?
Yes, it certainly is.
But there was only one little problem. You see, there were no eligible princes anywhere in the kingdom. And the king insisted that Cutie must marry a genuine prince.
My daughter, the Princess Cutie, will never marry anyone unless he is a first-class, honest-to-goodness, dyed-in-the-wool, guaranteed prince.
Now, at that moment, a terrible beast appeared and asked Cutie to marry him.
I am a terrible beast, and I would like you to marry me, Cutie.
Oh, she'd love to.
Father, how can you say that?
Now, how can you say that, Father? I mean, King, just a moment ago, you told everybody that your daughter had to marry a genuine A-number-one prince, right?
Ah, yes, Father.
So?
But I know how these stories always work out.
You do?
You see, that terrible beast is a prince that some witch has put a terrible spell on.
No kidding.
Sure, as soon as my daughter, the Princess Cutie, kisses that beast, he'll turn back into a prince.
Wow, I don't believe it.
Oh, sure.
Hello, Cutie.
Terrible beast?
Yes.
I think it's wonderful that you're going to marry my daughter.
Oh, I too think it is wonderful, oh noble king.
Of course, there is one small detail.
What is that?
First, you have to submit to the ordeal of what happens next.
The ordeal of what happens next?
That's right.
You did not tell me about this, Bobby.
I am going to show you three pictures.
Three pictures?
And you have to tell me in each one.
Yeah?
What happens next?
And if I do tell you? If I do tell you?
You can marry my daughter, the Princess Cutie.
Oh, boy. And if I do not tell you?
Then I throw you in a dungeon full of hoppy toads and itchy bugs.
That seems fair.
Will the terrible beast be able to pass the ordeal of what happens next and marry the princes? Or will he fail and be thrown into the dungeon full of hoppy toads and itchy bugs?
I don't know, Bob.
I don't know either, but you know, I do know something.
What's that?
I'm going to stay tuned for the second part of Cutie and the Beast and find out.
Okay, can I stay here and wait with you?
Oh, sure, I take care of you.
I'm scared.
Okay. Hey, Grover. Hey, listen, it's time for part two of Cutie and the Beast, Grover.
Oh, Bob, I am so scared.
No, don't be scared, Grover.
The ordeal of what happens next is next.
Yeah, I know it's next, but you can do it, Grover.
I can?
Yeah, chin up.
Chin up.
Chin up.
I can do it.
Good luck.
Oh, boy.
You can do it.
Okay.
I'll see you later. Now, as you remember, the terrible beast wants to marry the Princess Cutie, right? But first, he has to pass the ordeal of what happens next.
Oh, okay.
Right this way.
Yeah, Cutie, come here.
I'm coming.
All right.
Okay, I'm ready.
All right. Let's have the first picture, please.
Good luck, Beast.
Thank you. The first picture. Oh, there it is. Oh, what happens next? Let's see. There is a little kitty, and there is a table the kitty is on, and there is a little doggy there. And the doggy has scared the kitty, and the kitty has knocked over a vase, and what happens next is that the vase is going to fall on the doggy.
That is correct.
Oh, good. We threw now.
Now, wait. Yay. We have the second picture.
Second picture. Let me see.
Oh, goodness. You can do it.
Oh, there it is. Okay, let me see what happens next. There's a little boy, and he's sitting down with a fishing pole. And on the end of the string of the pole, there is a little worm on a hook. And there is water, and underneath the water, there is a fish. And the fish is going to bite the worm, and the little boy is going to catch the fish. Is that what happens next?
That is right.
That's what happens next. Oh, boy.
But wait.
What?
The last and most difficult one of all.
What?
Uh-oh.
The next and last picture.
Oh, let me see. Oh, that looks like a toughie.
Let me see.
What happens next. There is a car, and the car is moving, and the car is on the street, and there is a traffic light there, and the traffic light is red, and so what happens next is that I think the car stops.
That is the right answer.
Oh, Cutie! Oh, boy!
You win my daughter's hand in marriage.
Oh, boy! Oh,
hey, he was really terrific at that, huh? So what happens next now, I guess, is
what really happens next is the beautiful Princess Cutie kisses the terrible beast, and he turns into a handsome prince.
That's what really happens next, huh, King?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay, if you say so. So, now, Cutie kissed the beast. And what happens next was that Cutie turned into a beautiful lady beast.
Ooh.
What?
What?
I used to be a beautiful lady beast, but a long time ago, a witch cast a spell on me and turned me into a cute little princess.
These fairy tales never turn out the way you expect them to.
Cutie beast! Oh!
So what happens next is that everybody lives happily ever after. I guess.
Excuse me.
Watch it, lady.
Pardon me, Sonny.
Down below the street, can you dig your steady beat? It's a subway.
Subway!
Moving right along, hear the rhythm loud and strong. It's the subway.
Subway!
And there isn't any room in this town.
They put all the trains down under the ground.
Buy a token now for a ride in Super Wow on the subway.
Subway!
You should say you're sorry.
Squeeze inside the door.
They can't wear them anymore.
On the subway.
Subway!
Hang on to the strap.
Wonder where they hit the map.
On the subway. Subway!
Hurry, take the express.
It will go right by your local address.
Swaying to and fro, it's the only way to go on the subway.
Subway!
My
pocket
went
by.
Say you found it in my eye.
Oh,
it's so hot I could die.
Anyway, everywhere.
Packed inside a train, it's too crowded to complain on a subway.
Subway!
You can lose your purse or you might do something worse on the subway.
Subway!
It's a
biggest travel bargain in town.
The longest running show on the ground.
Come on, step inside, you'll get taken for a ride on the subway.
Where's that?
On the subway.
It will go right by your local address.
Buy a token now for a ride at Super Wow on the subway. On the subway.
On the subway.
Hi, do you know what this is? It's the letter S. And it stands not only for Superman, but for a lot of other words as well. Speed, for instance. And sky. And spaceship. S also stands for sea, and sailboat, and storm, and sinking, and save, and sand. Yes, sir, S is a very important letter. So the next time you think of Superman, think of the letter S. It's my favorite.
Presenting the further adventures of everybody's favorite hero, the man who is faster than lightning, stronger than steel, smarter than a speeding bullet. It's Super Grover!
And I am Choo-choo!
And now, on to our story.
Yes, on to our story!
One day, Super Grover was flying high over Metro City when suddenly, down below in Max's barbershop, he heard little willy-nilly crying.
No, I won't get a haircut.
But, Willie, you know that your mother wants you to get a haircut.
I don't care. Hark! What is that sound?
It's a bird.
A plane.
It's... It's Super Grover.
Are you all right, Super Grover?
I certainly hope so. We superheroes bruise easily, you know.
But Super Grover, what is the reason for you to drop in on us like this?
Super Grover heard a little child crying.
That was me. Huh? I don't want to get a haircut.
Well, why don't you want to get a haircut, little boy?
Because it will hurt.
Hurt? Hurt? Of course it will hurt! But you must be brave. You must smile through your tears. You must endure the agony, bear the pain, ignore the ouchness.
Willie, haircuts don't hurt.
Well,
no, it doesn't hurt to cut hair. Look, let me show you. I'll just cut a little piece of my own here. Now watch this. Watch closely. See that? There. See?
Did you see that? He cut his own hair and he did not even cry out in agony. What a brave, brave man.
Didn't that hurt?
No, Willie, it didn't hurt at all. Look, let me show you here. Just hold still now. Okay, and... There, see that?
Look at that! I do not believe it! That little boy did not even scream out in pain when his hair was cut. How come is that?
Because it didn't hurt.
Sure. You see, Grover? Come here a moment now.
What?
Grover, now just...
Well, no,
just
don't,
hold,
don't, please!
Just hold still
don't
a moment there,
please
Grover.
Don't,
and?
Please don't cut my fur! Please don't do it!
There.
Please don't do it!
Grover, look at this. Please. That's a little piece of your fur.
You cut my fur.
Mm-hmm, just a little bit.
I did not even feel it.
Sure.
You did not hurt me.
Sure.
Except I kind of felt a woofly feeling on my head. It's kind of nice.
I told you haircuts don't hurt. You ready for your haircut now, Willie?
Yeah, maybe okay. That'll be fun.
Hold still.
Well, it looks like Super Grover, noble hero of heroes, has done it again. I have made a great discovery. Haircuts do not hurt. No, and I must spread the word throughout the land. Haircuts do not hurt. Up, up, and away. Oh, my cape is caught on the hook. Ah!
Tune in next time when you will hear Super Grover say...
Haircuts do not hurt, but crashing through doors is quite painful. Ooh, boy.
Whew. Well, I'll be home just a little late tonight. I feel like Spider-Man. Oh, boy.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters G and R. And by the number 6. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.